Today's topic is demographic transition model. Now this topic is from the chapter population. Now we'll study what is demographic transition model. The change in population growth rate and the effect on population can be shown on the demographic transition model. So it is totally dependent on birth rate, death rate, okay, and what are the changes in the growth of the population or any type of declining of the population, the fluctuation of the population, it always changes. The population never remains constant. It always changes, and that changes can be shown with the help of demographic transition model. The population of every country keeps on changing, so it is necessary to note the change. So always as the people are migrating, the population keeps on changing. There are every day there are so many births, every day there are so many deaths. Because of this also the population keeps on changing. So it is very necessary to note all these changes, and we can do it with the help of demographic transition model. The model that describes population growth is called as demographic transition model. So you can see the population growth, also the decrease in the population. So all the factors can be seen with the help of this model. Now this model basically has four stages, okay, but in some countries the fifth stage is also used. Okay, the population of the country changes over four stages, and the fifth stage is added recently to show the population decline in some countries. Now generally the population is constant or the population keeps on rising, but there are some countries where the population is going in the negative case. So in such factors the decline stage is also added in the demographic transition model. So the countries like Germany and Sweden, they have a decline in the population ratio. So because of this the fifth stage is also added. Now this is the demographic transition model, which are having stage 1, that is high stationary, stage 2 early expanding, stage 3 late expanding, stage 4 low stationary, and stage 5 is declining. So basically this last stage is not used by all the countries, it is only used by some specific countries. Now you can see there are the three lines. First is yellow, second is green, and third is blue. Now the yellow line in this demographic transition model denotes the birth rate. So what is the birth rate, whether it is high, whether it is low. So it is denoted by the yellow line. Next, green line. So this green line denotes the death rate. So what is the current death rate is denoted by this green line. And this blue line is used to denote the total population. So in this figure, you can see how is the trend or how is the stage of each and every line. Okay. Now at the x-axis you have time. So according to the time, they are showing the birth rate, death rate, and total population. And on the y-axis you have birth and death rate per 1000 people. So birth and death rate per 1000 people is shown on the y-axis. So let us study each and every stage one by one. Now let us study each and every stage one by one. The stage one is also called as high stationary stage. The main characteristic of this stage is that birth rate and death rate both are high. The number of people taking birth is also high, and the number of people dying every day is also high. So because of this, there is very less growth in population. The population is basically stable. Example, rainforest. As both the birth rate and death rates are high during this phase, the population growth is very much stable. It is totally balanced. Birth rates are high because of having a lot of children is considered to be a good idea. So as there are so many of children, because of this the birth rate is high. At this stage, the financial position of the country is not developed. So because of this stability, there is no change, and the financial condition of the country is also not much developed. It is dependent on agriculture or similar primary occupation. People are engaged in secondary and tertiary activities are negligible. So in this stage, what happens? द पीपल इन द स्टेज आर एंगेज्ड इन द बेसिक ऑक्यूपेशन इनिशियली प्राइमरी ऑक्यूपेशंस एंड वेरी लेस अमाउंट ऑफ पीपल आर एंगेज्ड इन सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शरी ऑक्यूपेशन एजुकेशनल अपॉर्चुनिटीज आर लिमिटेड फर्टिलिटी रेट्स आर हाई फैमिलीज आर बिग सो एज द एजुकेशन इज ऑल्सो लेस द फर्टिलिटी रेट एंड द फैमिलीज आर ऑल्सो बिग साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी आर नॉट डेवलप्ड लो सैनिटेशन High occurrence of contagious disease, lack of medical facilities and malnutrition are responsible for high death rates. At present, no country falls in this category. Because of low education, because of the people are engaged in the primary occupation, the financial condition of this country is very less. The science and technology is also not developed. Because of this, high occurrence of contagious diseases are more. Medical facility is less. Malnutrition conditions are also more. Because of this, there is very less development at this stage. But at present, in today's situation, not a single country falls in this category. Now we'll study about the stage 2. The stage 2 is called as early expanding. In this stage, the birth rate remains high as the birth like stage 1 the birth rate remains high only the change is in the death rate is falling population begins to rise steadily so as the death rate is falling and the birth rate is high means every day the children are taking birth but the people those who are dying that is very much less because of this what happens there is more population growth So, where is this seen? It is seen in the countries like Bangladesh, Nigeria and Sri Lanka. Now, what happens in this country? The technology expansion of science occurs and development starts. Medical and healthcare services starts expanding. Efforts are underway to control the combined disease and this leads to reduction in mortality but the death rate is constant. So, because of good development, because of good science and technology and medical and healthcare facilities, there is very much less death rate and also the reduction of mortality. As a result, the population grows rapidly. Production in agriculture and industry increases. Transportation network increases. Efforts to control the population are launched. So, as the population is more, the production of agriculture and industry is also more. Transportations are also increasing. So, as everyone should make use of it. So, because of this, the Developing countries with high populations are currently undergoing this phase. So all the developing countries which are between underdeveloped and developed countries, they come under this category. This stage is also known as population explosion phase as it has the highest growth rate as shown in the following example. So it has the highest growth rate because of this it is called as population explosion. So the characteristic of stage 2 that is early expanding, the characteristic is what? The birth rate remains high and the death rate is falling. Because of this, the population is increasing very fast and this phase is also called as population explosion. And the countries under this phase are most probably the developing countries and they are the countries like Bangladesh, Sri Lanka belongs to this type of category. Now the next stage is stage 3 that is late expanding. The characteristic of this stage is that the birth rate is falling as well as the death rate is falling. But the thing is what? The population is still rising. So what is the reason that the population is still rising? The reduced death rate is the second stage is still decreasing in this stage 2. So what did we see in the first stage? That both the birth rate and death rate both are increasing. What did we see in the second stage? The birth rate is increasing but the death rate is decreasing. Now in the third stage, same thing is seen that the death rate is still decreasing like the second stage. Birth rates are also decreasing now. Along with the death rates, even the birth rate is decreasing in the stage 3. So it should reduce the population growth. But what happens? In this case, the population is still growing. Why? Because the birth rates are higher than the death rates. So, how many people are taking birth? That is always higher than the people dying. Because of this, there is still the growth in the population. As the progress of the country is accelerating, the income of the people is above the subsistence level, the standard of living is elevated, and poverty is decreasing. So as many people are taking birth as compared to the people dying, this country is progressing day by day. Okay, the standard of living of this country is also good. Because of this, they use new technology and their secondary and tertiary activities are also expanded. And hence, this is the reason that the poverty of this country is decreasing. Education level of the population is increasing, whereas family planning is also given a more importance. Because of this, the family size reduces. Countries that are moving towards developed stage from developing are going through this stage. For example, China. So, in the first stage, what did we see? That not a single country belongs to the first stage. That is the high stationary stage. And in the second stage, which countries are belonging? All the developing countries like Bangladesh and Nigeria. And in the third stage, the countries, those who are moving towards developed, means almost they have crossed the developing phase and they are almost very much near to the developed stage, such countries comes under the third stage category, that is the late expanding category. An example is China. Let us study the stage 4, that is the low stationary stage. Now this is low fluctuation. This is a low fluctuating stage where the birth rate and death rate both are low. Now in this case, both the things are lowest. Because of that, the population is very steady. The birth rate is the third stage now lowers further and the standard of the living is very high. So as the birth rate is also low, the death rate is also low, the population is also less and the standard of living is also high. The economic condition of this country and the economic status of the citizens improves a lot. As the population is in control, the economic condition and the status of this country is very much nice. Secondary and tertiary occupations are very much higher than the primary occupations. The death rate is also very low as because of the developed facilities of medicines. Epidemics like plague, cholera have also been eliminated. So because of this, people are very much conscious about their health. The birth rate is not less than the death rate, but it is almost the same. So this is the phase where both the death rate and the birth rate are low, but they are almost the same. They are totally balanced. Therefore, the population growth is minimal. And in this phase, which countries belong? The developed countries like USA are going through this phase. So as you know that USA is a very much developed country, so this country belongs to the low stationary phase. The last phase is declining phase. Now this is the phase where birth rate is dropping below the death rate, means how many people are dying more than that, the birth is dropping. So example, Germany and Sweden. It includes the countries in which fertility rates have fallen significantly below the replacement level and the elderly population is greater than the youthful population. So the old people are more than the new people, that is the small children. The birth rate is very low and almost equal the death rate. So birth rate is either less than death rate or it is equal to the death rate. Population growth is minimal or in some countries could be negative. So the population growth is always less or it is in the negative structure. The population may be reduced because of higher mortality. In such countries, the number of children is very low and elderly are very much high. So as mortality is high, what is the meaning of mortality? When a child takes a birth and he dies within a year, then we called it as infant mortality. Yes, or when the child at a very initial younger stage he dies, then we also called it as mortality. So because of this, the number of children is low and old people are high. So the standard of living is also very high. The economic condition of the country and the citizens is very good. Tertiary activities are mostly seen in this type of countries. High quality of education, medical facilities are available, healthy environment and pleasant life is preferred. So here the standard of living is good, economic condition is good, high quality of education and medical facilities are seen. People are mostly engaged in the tertiary activities, and because of this, there is healthy environment and pleasant life. So which are the countries which come under this category? Germany, Sweden, Finland are the countries which come under the stage 5, that is the declining stage. Now, limitations of demographic transition model. Like any model, there will be outliers and expectations to rule, exceptions to rule, and the demographic transition model is not different. So in this model, what will happen? If there are some exceptions or if some exception is created, then this model cannot calculate or cannot find out the difference in it. Additionally, there are things the demographic transition model cannot relieve. What are the things? The impact of other demographic variables such as migration are not considered, nor does this model predict how long a country will be in each stage. So if the people are migrating from one country to another country, that migration is not included or not considered, as well as it is also not predicted that which country is going to remain in which stage. It always keep the country in a particular stage. It doesn't fluctuate, or it cannot predict that in future which country is going to be in which stage. But even so, the relationship between birth rate, death rate is an important concept when discussing population and any pattern, such as those provided by demographic transition model that aided in understanding or helpful. But still, after all these things, we at least get the relationship between the birth rate and death rate and how it is important for the population growth and its pattern. And it is very helpful to understand also.